Our next speaker is Mrs. Trupti Patel. Mrs. Trupti Patel is an engineer, consultant, and trainer by profession. But above all, she is the current president of the new solar company, the largest umbrella body for British unions. Trupti founded a supplementary arts school and successfully managed a number of commercial divisions and charities. She assists and advises various organizations and individuals of the community in various aspects of life, like startups, arts projects, strategy development, and also women's projects ranging from the access provisions to drafting mails, all in a fully voluntary capacity. This is pretty good. Good evening, everyone. Good evening,
both.
Hello, everyone. Lots of things have been said so far. Quite a lot of things have been said for pro-caste clause and a little bit about why we should not have the clause. I just want to mention a few things for you before we set a scene. When this came out in 2008, we actually went around the country, or we went around larger temples, smaller temples, gurudwaras, and we had the consultation done. And the report was published, and everybody can access it if they want to. And we did not find that there was a problem amongst the Hindus and Sikhs that the caste was discriminatory. People knew their caste. My best friends are from different castes. But there was no question. Nobody said to us that there is a problem. I've been discriminated on my caste base. And I can definitely tell you that because I've been to most of the temples in this country and I have met most of the trustees and most of the people at various events that is going on. If someone, or less than 1%, is experiencing that, that does not mean that we need that clause into this act. Yeah? Now, what I've been told by Prabhakarji is that I should talk about the implication of the clause being enacted or passed through the secondary legislation. And what I thought was very clearly that, as people mentioned before, the current legislation at the moment deals with the inequalities, it deals with your race, your religion, it deals with you as a human, you as a person, your human right. If you then add caste clause into it, that means that you are telling me, when we come to doing the forms for any, like I've just recently filled the form for the NHS because I've moved home. Are you English? Are you this? Are you this? Are you that? Okay, are you Indian? Are you Hindu? Are you Christian? Are you Muslim? And then, where is going to be this thing? Are you going to be, which caste are you? Which caste am I? I'm a Patel. I'm a Patel who comes from the landowners community. Sure, but I also know Patels. I also know Patels who are the people who deal the lands. I know people, the Patels are married into Punjabis. Patels married into English. So what happens to that generation? What caste is my niece or my nephew? It is, we are actually trying to segregate people by default in that sense, and we are actually creating that segregation amongst not only our own people, but also if you are Mr. Carpenter, Mr. Goldsmith, if you are Mr. Fisher, I mean, what? Are you a machi? Are you Mr. Fisher? How is Mr. Fisher going to answer to this question? What caste are you? If he refuses to say what caste am I, then what my right is going to refuse that what caste am I? Or our children will say, well, why is caste matter in this country? We live in UK. I've been living here for 40 years and I've got experience. Anybody telling me, I've got a Brahmin friends, I've got Chamar friends, I've got Mochi friends, they've got their society, they come to our temples, celebrate Navratri, Diwali, everything. So nobody does that. And I just honestly feel that it's like cracking a nut with a sledgehammer. Now, if we actually think about it, we want a community cohesion. We worked hard for interfaith. We worked hard for community cohesion. What is this going to do? It's going to create lots of animosity between people. It's also going to open floodgates into lots of cases, fake cases maybe, but that is maybe. But the most important thing it will do is create in people's mind, oh, I'm a Brahmin child, so I'm higher than you, or I'm superior than you, or I'm a Dalit child, so am I really lower than you? But no, you're not, you are a human being. And when I teach, I'm a teacher. I'm a dance teacher when I teach dance. When I'm doing my work, I'm an engineer. Yeah, but when I'm doing seva, I'm a sutra. And I have no problem with that. Everybody should be thinking on that highest level of themselves and bring the society upwards. And not fight towards saying we want these caste laws in the UK equality law. Because what happens next? Are we going to have all the government bodies and all the police and the schools and everybody? How are we going to classify people into the caste? So you're again forcing people into this classification system. Do we have resources? No, we don't have resources to either classify or to actually implement anything like that. So the machinery to deal with this little clause is going to be tremendous if we do go ahead and put that clause in. And again, like I said, division is not something that we should be really going for. For the Samaj, that is a completely different matter. It was mentioned here. If I'm from, say, a Chogam Patidar Samaj, and if I say that I don't want my daughter to marry into a Punjabi boy, that is something which is emotional, social, is different. But it's not happening here. We know that majority of the people in our community now intermarrying with the white community, black community, with Punjabis, Gujaratis, South Indians. So I just don't see that relevance of these caste laws. It's also claimed that we got so many 100,000 Dalits in this country, and they all been being discriminated. Yeah, we all been told that once the bill we'll have hundreds and thousands of cases because everybody will be knocking on the door saying I've been discriminated. We've only had one case, the Chandra versus Tigray case, and this is not the place to actually go into it. The way it was all muddled, molded. And another thing as well to look into it was the report that was mentioned. And I have also got the full report on my iPad, and also the research done by few organizations onto the flaws of that report. So let's just put that on one side, those reports, because we can equally put our reports, or when I say our reports means the community's reports as well, rebutting that. The fundamental human right is that I do not want to be labeled in UK in any way, form or shape saying that I am lower than anybody else or I am higher than anybody else. I am Atma. When we say Namaste, we are all equal, and I believe in that. Thank you very much.